Hello, welcome to SS Unitech. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we gonna discuss about execute SQL task parameter mapping. So here I have created two scenarios. First, we want to insert record into a table by using variables, and second, we want to execute a store procedure with parameter. So in our first query, as we can see, if we want to use variables to insert record in our table, then we have to specify values by question mark, and then we can map those question marks with our variables. So go to on SSDT, and here I would like to add one more package. So then I wish to rename this package with execute SQL task parameter mapping. Now I need to drag and drop execute SQL task, then double click on this execute SQL task. And here I would like to use OLADB as a connection type. Then I need to build a connection manager. So as I have already made the connection, so I gonna use that one. So click on OK. In SQL query, I would like to paste our insert statement. So I have already written the insert statement. So I would like to copy this and need to paste that query in our SSDT. So before going to paste this query into SSDT, let's have a look of table. So it has 8 rows. So go to on SSDT and paste that query and click on OK. So here we need to create 4 variables. So first I would like to create 4 variables. This is for ID and value should be integer, and I would like to add ID 9. Second, it should be name and it should be string value, and what would be the value? Value would be John. In third variable, this is for date of birth, and here we need to specify our date, and I would like to use 2019 0101. Then in last variable, this is for salary. So it should be integer and value would be 52,000. So these are the values in our variables. So I would like to use these variables to map with our question mark. So go to on parameter mapping, and here I would like to add 4 parameters, and this is for ID. So we can select our ID. Second, we need to select for name. Then we need to select for date of birth, and last we need to select for salary, and direction should be input. Then what would be the output data type? So for ID it should be numeric data type. Then for name it should be varchar. Then this is for date, so we need to select date. Then for salary again we need to select numeric. And what would be the parameter name? So this is our first parameter, so we need to specify 0. This is second, so 1, then 2, then 3. It will start from left side. So our first parameter would be ID, then name, date of birth and salary. So we have done our mapping. Now we can click on OK. And we can save our package and click on start. So package executed successfully. We can stop this package, go to on SSMS, and we can press Ctrl R. So as we can see, ID 9 has been inserted successfully. If I want to update our name for ID 2 and we want to update with Shiv Singh, then how we can update? By using execute SQL task. So this is our update statement which I have written. So we can copy and go to on SSDT, double click on this execute SQL task, and instead of this SQL statement I would like to paste our update statement. So here as we can see, our name parameter comes first. For name it would be 0, for ID it would be 1. Now click on OK, go to on parameter mapping, and here I wish to remove our date of birth and salary. And here, as we can see, this is ID and this is name. So put 1 for the ID and 0 for the name. Now click on OK. Now we can save it. Go to on variables, and here I wish to change the values. So I wanna change with Shiv Singh, and ID would be 2. Now we can save it and execute our package. So package executed successfully. Now go to on SSMS, and in this table I need to press Ctrl R. So as you can see, ID2's name has been updated. So here I have created a simple store procedure. So in this store procedure, it accepts a parameter with ID and it will return the ID name and date of birth. So I would like to create this store procedure. So store procedure created successfully. Now if I execute this store procedure for ID1, then it should return information of ID1. So we are getting ID name and date of birth. I can press question mark, copy this execute statement and go to on execute SQL task and stop this package. Now double click on this, and here I can paste, and it accept ID. Now click on OK. Go to on parameters. So I have removed name. Then we need to add two real sets. So first for the 0, then 1, and we are getting 2 as well. So first is ID. So I would like to for ID. Second, we are getting name. Then we are getting date of birth. So now I need to click on OK. So by using script task, we can check our output. So I would like to drag and drop script task and connect with execute SQL task. Double click on this script task, read only variables. I need to select our date of birth and second name. Now click on OK. So go to on edit script. Here I need to use message box dot so DTS dot variables, and here we need to specify variable name, that is date of birth, then dot value, then dot to string. So this is for date of birth. Second, we want to use for name, so we can specify name. Now we can save it and close it. Click on OK. So we have done our package. Now I wish to execute our package. So as we can see, this is the date of birth and this is the name. Now I gonna stop this package and go to on variables. I need to change the ID. So we want to output for ID3. Stop this. Go to on SSMS. So here, as we can see, for ID3 we are getting Vipul. So in our output we should get Vipul. We can execute our package, and this is date of birth and this is Vipul. So we are getting as we were expected. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.